हाय गाइस, माय नेम इज़ अनुज जिंदल। वेलकम टू दिस सेशन। तो आज के सेशन में हम एग्जैक्टली क्या क्या बात करने वाले हैं ये मैं आपको बता देता हूँ, एंड देन वी विल स्टार्ट विद दिस सेशन। तो आज हमारा जो सेशन है दैट इज़ गोइंग टू बी अबाउट क्वेश्चंस ऑन डेवलपमेंट इश्यूज। डेवलपमेंट इश्यूज के कुछ क्वेश्चंस उठाएंगे। नाउ विच ऑल एग्जाम्स आर वी गोइंग टू कवर थ्रू दीज क्वेश्चंस, दिस एमसीक्यू सीरीज। दो एग्जाम्स हैं जो कि आ रहे हैं स्पेसिफिकली ASRB ICAR, जहाँ पे बहुत सारी वैकेंसीज आई हैं, एंड सेकेंडली इज ESIC, एम्प्लॉय स्टेट इंश्योरेंस कॉरपोरेशन का जो एग्ज़ाम है, जिसमें 151 वैकेंसीज हैं, विच इज़ अ लॉट। दोनों ही एग्जाम्स में हमारे पास काफ़ी टाइम है, वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम टू प्रिपेयर, एंड दैट इज़ वाई आई एम स्टार्टिंग विद दीज MCQ सीरीज। ओके, इसमें अलग अलग हमारे जो फैकल्टी मेम्बर्स हैं, टीम मेम्बर्स हैं, अलग अलग टॉपिक्स उठाएंगे। आई विल बी पिकिंग अप डेवलपमेंट इशूज एंड पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन फॉर ESIC। डेवलपमेंट इश्यूज में क्या क्या आता है वो हम ओवर टाइम इन क्वेश्चंस के थ्रू समझ लेंगे। इफ यू वांट टू गो फॉर द कोर्स, अ ब्रीफ डिस्कशन अबाउट द कोर्स। इफ यू वांट टू गो फॉर द कोर्स, यू कैन गो फ्रॉम द वेबसाइट, बाय कोर्सेज में जाएंगे। बोथ दीज कोर्सेज आर अवेलेबल हेयर, ASRB F&AO फॉर AO बाय ICAR एज वेल एज ESIC डिप्टी डायरेक्ट। This is the price, but there is a 40% discount going on presently on both the courses, and therefore you can choose both the courses or any one of the courses, it will be enough for you. ठीक है, दोनों के सिलेबस में कुछ differences हैं, but development issues is one topic which is common in both the examinations. Exactly same terminology use किया गया है, so the preparation is also going to be very very similar for both these examinations. Okay, if we talk about ASRB, then there are three courses which are running at the moment. One is only for AO, one is for F&AO, and one is for both AO as well as F&AO. So if you are from finance background, if you are eligible to write F&AO, you can use these courses as well. Having said that, let us start with the session. एक चीज मैं और आपके साथ शेयर करना चाहता हूँ। I would request every student, whoever is watching this, to please take a pen and paper. 2 मिनट लगते हैं, pen and paper लीजिए और जो भी आंसर आपको लगता है, वट एवर आंसर यू फील इज करेक्ट फॉर दिस, प्लीज मार्क दैट और राइट दैट इन योर पेपर। ओके, ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम यूज दैट सेम पेपर एवरी डे। ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम दिस इज गोइंग टू हेल्प यू अलॉट इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग वेदर योर स्कोर इज इंप्रूविंग और रिड्यूसिंग, हाउ वट इज हैपनिंग टू योर स्कोर्स, वट इज योर कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल। बहुत सारी चीजें हैं जो यहाँ पर आप जज कर सकते हैं अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस सीरीज। ओके, सो प्लीज गेट अ पेन एंड पेपर एंड स्टार्ट राइटिंग, नॉट द क्वेश्चंस। यू डोंट नीड टू राइट द क्वेश्चंस, वी डोंट वांट टू। You can watch it anytime later on and you can write these questions. But when you're watching it for the first time, please make sure कि आप इसके answer एक committed तरीके से, एक religious तरीके से आप लिख रहे हैं, so that you understand whether your answers are right or wrong and where are you going wrong. Okay. With that, let's start with the first question. The first question is, what is the target set under for renewable energy set by the government of India to be achieved by 2030? Now this target has been recently revised and that is why this question becomes very important. The options are 175, 400, 450 gigawatt, 250 and 350 gigawatt. The answer to this question is C, 450 gigawatt. Pehle 500 tha, it used to be 500 gigawatt, but now it has been revised at 450 gigawatt to be achieved by 2030. Now please remember that this is for the entire renewable energy and not for solar. The targets for solar are different and we'll be covering that over a period of time as well. If you want to Google it, you can Google it right away after this session and you can figure out it for yourselves as well. Okay, so I hope this is clear. The answer to this question is C, 450 gigawatt. Let's come to the next question. The second question that we have is, which of the following statements are true? Statement based question, thoda lamba hoga, but these are the kinds of questions that are expected in the examination. You will not get direct questions, jaisa maine abhi pucha tha. There might be some indirect questions or statement based questions as well. The question says, which of the following statements are true? We have to figure out the true statement. Please keep this in mind. A lot of students get this wrong, get these kinds of questions wrong, because at times they might ask you about the false statement or incorrect statement as well. Anyways, in this case, we have to figure out which of the following statements are true and not false. Growth is a quantitative aspect while development is a qualitative aspect. I think this is true, makes very lot of sense. Growth is not possible without development. development includes growth too. If you're clear about the idea of or the philosophy behind growth and development, fundamental aspects about growth and development, then it is a very simple question for you. If you've not read the basics of growth and development, then this might create some problems. Okay, very simple question. I would say development includes growth too. Yes, this is correct. Growth is not possible without development. This is incorrect, because development is not possible without growth, but there can be growth without development. Development is not possible without growth. So if there is no growth, there can be no development, but if there is no development, there can still be growth. Leading examples, India ek bahut bada example hai jahan pe bahut sare aspects mein we have been growing very fast for quite some time, but when it comes to areas of development or ideas of development, components of development, there we feel that we are lacking in a lot of areas. So the second one is incorrect. 1 and 3 are correct. That makes our answer as D. Option D is our correct answer option. Let's come to the next one. Yahan par diya hua hai, answer option is D. Which of the following sustainable development goals aims to achieve universal and equitable access to safe and affordable drinking water for all by 2030? Very important. Ek to statement mein ye question answer ho raha hai. There is another question which is being answered is, we have to ensure universal access to drinking water and sanitation for all by 2030. That is a target under sustainable development goals. Not only the goals are important, the targets under sustainable development goals are also important. And we'll be picking up some questions from those targets also. So not only the 17 goals that you have, but 169 targets that you have, usme se major, there are 2030 targets which are major ones. You should have a good idea about them. Aapko wo yaad hone chahiye. You should have memory of them. Okay. Anyways, coming back to the question, which of the following SDGs is focused upon affordable drinking water and sanitation for all by 2030? The answer is B, SDG 6. It's very pertinent, very important that you remember all the SDGs. Jitne bhi SDGs hain, unke number, unke exact wordings. In fact, abhi ek question uthayenge, which is very confusing for a lot of students. So, ye aapko yaad hone chahiye. Okay. SDG 6 aims at achieving universal and equitable access to safe and affordable drinking water by 2030. These are the 17 goals that we have. Inko please yaad kariye. You have to remember them. You cannot afford to not know them, because these are low hanging fruits. These are very easy questions, very easy information. You can remember it very, very easily. Okay. Do it for 1 or 2 days. Revise it once or twice along with the targets and you're done. You will never get any questions wrong. And because the topic specifically says development issues, I'm expecting some questions from either Millennium Development Goals or Sustainable Development. Chances are higher that we will have questions from SDGs, because they're already under implementation now. Okay. So these are the 17 goals that we have. As you can see, the 6th goal here says clean water and sanitation. It includes drinking water as well, okay, under its targets. So this is SDG 6. Let's come to the next question. Leave no one behind is a key message throughout the 2030 agenda for sustainable development. Goal 1 is about poverty. What is the aim of this goal? Very, very important question. Dekhiye, jaise humne 2030 ka ek dekha, water and sanitation, universal access. Similarly, we have a similar target for poverty as well, which says leave no one behind, which means they are implying universal eradication of poverty by 2030. We have to remove poverty by 2030. That is the goal that we have under SDG. Usko question karne se koi fayda nahi hai. You cannot question it and say we are never going to achieve this, etc., etc. This is the target or the goal that we have, universal eradication of poverty in all its forms by 2030. Okay. The options are cut poverty in half by 2030, cut poverty by 75% by 2030. I've already answered the question. End poverty in all its forms everywhere by 2030. This is our correct answer. Help each nation in reducing poverty by 75% by 2025. You might get confused at times if you're not clear about the targets. Now, these statements have been picked up from the targets. There might be a situation again where you might be given these four statements and you have to figure out which of the following statements are correct and which ones are incorrect. Or ho sakta hai, let's say the target is, actual target is 75% by 2025. For example, this is a hypothetical example that I'm taking. Let's say the targets say cut poverty by 75% by 2025 and 100% by 2030. Then B and C both are correct. Okay. So that kind of statement based questions can also be asked in the examination. The answer option, as I said, is C. Next question, there are 169 targets for the 17 goals, as I had said. Each target has between 1 and 3 indicators used to measure progress towards reaching the targets. In total, there are 232 approved indicators that will measure compliance. The United Nations Development Programme has been asked to provide easy to understand lists of targets, facts and figures. Which of the following SDG pertains to good governance? Very beautiful question. Because good governance is never not mentioned in the 17 goals that we have. Nahin pa mentioned nahi hai directly. But it implies, and in the explanation, if you go through the explanation of these 17 goals, you will realize that one of these SDGs, which does not mention good governance, talks about good governance. Okay. So the answer options that we have are SDG 17, SDG 16, SDG 15 and SDG 14. The answer to this question is B, SDG 16. Let's have a look at what exactly is happening here. So these are the 17 goals that we have. Out of this, the 16th one says peace, justice and strong institutions. Okay, peace, justice and strong institutions. When can you say that you have good governance? When there is justice in the system, when the institutions are working properly for the people, by the people. Very important. Okay, democracy ke andar, when do we say we have good governance? When there is justice in the system and when the institutions are working properly, are working at their full strength, are working without any hindrance or interference by the executive or by any other party or by any other institution. Okay, that is when we can say that we are moving towards good governance. These are two basic elements of good governance. Good governance as a whole is a big topic, jiske liye alag se discussion zaruri hai, but here it gives you an idea that they can use terminologies which are meant by these words which have been mentioned. It might not be directly related to, or it might not be directly picked up from these words itself. Okay, because this is talking about good governance, so instead of writing justice and strong institutions, I mentioned good governance, and that is where a lot of students get confused. Okay, so ye ho gaya hamara aaj ka next question jisme we have talked about good governance. So this was all for this session, very small session, but nicely made, I believe. Kuch na kuch fayda hua hoga SDGs ke bare mein thoda sa aur pata laga hoga. And I'm sure that if you've not read about SDGs till now, you will start your Google and start reading more about SDGs. Aur agle aadha ghante mein, ek ghante mein, you will have a very good idea about sustainable development. This was all for this session. All the best guys. Take care. Bye-bye.